What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, we have the Lenovo ThinkPad P15 Generation 2 mobile workstation. We not too long ago did an unboxing slash review on it, and today is all about configuring it so we can start cryptocurrency mining. So let's get right into it. So first thing that I like to do is I'm going to right click on the taskbar. I'm going to go to Task Manager. I'm going to open up this dialog box, go to Performance, and then go inside the GPU. Now, one of the cool things about the P15 is that it is housing an NVIDIA RTX A5000 graphics card with 16 gigs. So this guy is going to run super smooth. I can't wait to see the highest hash rate on this machine. This machine is not configured for discrete mode. It's configured as hybrid mode. And the way that I know it's configured as hybrid mode is that I'm able to see GPU 0 and GPU 1. If it was on discrete mode, we are only able to see the NVIDIA card. I'm going to show you guys how to configure that, but before we do that, we need to do a couple of things on the machine. So I'm going to close this window up and I'm going to click on start, and I'm going to type in power option. And within the power options, I like to make sure that plugged in is never, because I don't want the machine to go asleep on me when it's mining. And the next thing that we need to do is configure your Windows updates. It's the worst case scenario to have your machine mining and it's just going at it. It's trying to solve algorithms and then push it back to the pool so you can get paid. And all of a sudden your machine restarts because of a Windows updates. That's horrible, right? I'm gonna click on the Windows key and type in Windows services, hit enter. I'm gonna open this guy up. We're gonna go all the way to the bottom and we are going to locate Windows update. Double click on that. We're going to stop it. We are going to make sure it is disabled. We're going to apply it. And from here, we are going to go inside recovery tab and make sure that the first failure is on take no action and then apply it. Okay. Next thing that we need to do is if you do a Windows I command, we're going to go to updates and security. Within updates and security, we're going to click on pause updates for 7 days. If you want, you're able to go to advanced options and just pause the updates to a longer period. And I'm able to go into January 1st of 2022. Awesome. Another way to disable updates is if you click on start and just type in GP edit and click enter to get inside the local group policy editor. I'm going to open up this window, and within computer configuration, we're going to expand administrative templates. We're going to go inside Windows components, and from here we want to locate Windows updates. And the option that we are looking for is configure automatic updates. So we're going to double click on that and we are going to click on disable, apply it, okay it, and you should be good to go. Before I restart the machine, I have my trusty USB drive with my mining software. So I'm going to plug it in. Awesome. And first thing to do is we are going to make a folder with this name on the desktop. Okay. Paste that there. And I'm going to do a Windows I. And within Windows I, I'm going to go inside the updates and security. And within there, we are going to go to Windows security. We're going to click on virus and threat protection. Let's open this dialog box up. And we need to locate the option that says manage settings underneath the virus and threat protection settings. So click on that. And we need to locate the following section where it says exclusion. So click on add or remove and then add a folder. And we want to add this particular folder. We don't want this folder to be scanned. By doing this, this basically excludes Microsoft Defender from scanning that folder. That's a good thing, because if not, it will remove the exe file and then your mining will stop. So let's close that up. Close this up. And I'm going to double click here and I'm going to copy everything into my folder on the desktop. Awesome. All right, great. Everything is copied over to the desktop folder and we're going to close this window up. I'm going to click on this little arrow and I'm going to click here and I'm going to remove the disk. Awesome. This is remove. Great. I'm going to double click on that folder. I'm going to go inside this folder and I am going to right click on start underscore miner and click on edit. Everything is already preset, but the only thing that I want to do here is change the name of the worker. It is not the P620. It is basically the P15. This will basically tell me which worker is doing what behind the scenes. And we are going to do a control S to save it. And we're going to close that window. Okay, so let's configure our graphics mode. So I'm going to close this guy up. I'm going to do a Windows I command. I'm going to go inside updates and security. Within here, let's go inside the recovery section. We're going to click on restart now under the advanced startup. And it's going to restart. Now from here, we're going to pick troubleshoot. The P15 is touchscreen, so I'm going to take advantage of that and then click on it. Awesome. From this menu, we are going to pick on advanced options. And we're going to pick on the firmware settings. And we're going to definitely restart the machine. All right, so it finally booted to the BIOS firmware setting. And we are going to go to configure. Within configure, we are going to click on display. And underneath where it says graphic device, by default, it is set up to hybrid. We're going to click on the drop-down menu and switch it to discrete. And we are going to click on F10. And save configuration changes and exit now. Yes. And awesome. So let it reboot and we're going to check out the new settings. All right. So the P15 Gen 2 finally booted up. We made some changes within the firmware. We changed the hybrid to discrete. And the way that you could double check it is right click on the taskbar, go to task manager. Let's open up this window. Let's go to performance. And now you're going to see only one graphics card. Before we saw GPU 0 and then GPU 1. Now we only see GPU 0, which is the NVIDIA RTX A5000 with 16 gigs. Awesome. So now we are all set. And the next thing that we need to do is let's go inside a folder. Within that folder, I am going to double click here and I'm going to start my miner. Now, before I start the miner, I like to use Tech Power Up. And the reason why I like to use this utility is if you go inside sensors, it gives you a nice overview of the temperature, the memory, the GPU overload. It gives you a good summary or a bird's eye view of everything that's happening on the graphics card. So I definitely have this up and running when I start the miner. So I'm going to double click on this guy. Awesome. You're going to get this Windows firewall block some features of this app. So I'm going to do allow. And that's it. Awesome. It is mining. So I'm going to leave this be for a couple of weeks. I will follow up with you guys to see how well this graphics card works with this particular machine. And hopefully you guys enjoy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.